I think the key element of technology will be that we manage to convince people to give us data which allows the relevance function of the system to serve them better. So don't expect magical new plumbing. I always say the 90s were the decade, given a set of data, what insights can I get? Whereas the 2000s is a decade, given a problem, what data do I need to go out and get in order to solve my problem? So let's say the problem of relevance is not solved by yet smarter algorithms. We have reached the ceiling there. But it is solved by people coming up with smart incentives where people see that, hey, if I show you something about myself, then I'll be served much better by you. My attention will be rewarded more richly and I'll be disappointed less. So my view is that companies that will be successful will see that the consumer is not their enemy. So it's not about snooping up behind the consumer, getting their digital exhaust and then selling the stuff they don't want, because that's not how it works. But the companies who will be successful are those who manage to enroll the consumer in helping them and helping themselves. That's how they get people to share stuff, not because they want to primarily help the company, but primarily themselves. And we see in China, product development for cars being driven by consumers. That there's an example of a Japanese car maker who actually had a piece made for the car by consumers without having any say in that. People said, we need this, and someone stepped up and said, yes, I have a company in Guangzhou which can produce it, and there you go. Not only user-created content, but user-created products. That's part of what I see the future of communication to be. The shift that has occurred is that the relevant cost of the recipient is now the dominant ones. No longer, if you think about sending out mail 10, 20 years ago, the $1 which the sender has to pay. So the intelligence used to sit on the side of the sender, for instance, Capital One, carefully figuring out who to target. But with electronic communication, the cost has shifted to the recipient of our time, of our attention, of our interrupt cost to deal with the interrupts. And my belief is that it's not primarily a technology play, but it's primarily a people play where people provide metadata. Data where they predict how important their communication is for you, and then a model negotiates over time, given their reputation, how much you should be interrupted, and whether in a given situation you're in, which of course your device measures much more finely than ever before, in a given situation, whether you should be interrupted or not. I do believe that relevance, progress in relevance for you as an individual, is one of the key things to expect in the near future. For instance, if you take Twitter, Twitter organizes things by time. What a poor way. It's one way, but it's a very poor way. It's understandable by the user, but it doesn't really help me to manage my attention well. So potentially, Twitter knows a lot about my past actions. Who did I reply to? Who do I follow? And also, maybe, how do others reply to? What do others think about messages? And what do I do in other networks? Are the people who I follow on Twitter, are they also on my Facebook? Are they in my MySpace? Do I send email to them? So taking all that information together, I believe we can build a much better system which shows the stuff which seems to be relevant to me as opposed to just showing stuff in chronological order. We have seen the cost of communications across the board come down. That means lots more gets produced by lots of more people. And the necessary requirement now is that the sender, having an easy ability to reach everybody, needs to be matched by the receiver, which has some way of actually cutting through all the stuff and just finding those nuggets. So in some way, it used to be that search was the paradigm where I go and I find something, but now it's more discovery. Hey, delight me, show me some stuff you're interested in. So why do people share things about themselves? Well, I did a panel with Shoshana Zuboff and Esther Dyson at the Fortune Brainstorm Conference. And the upshot was, people like to spread their genes and people like to spread their memes. So both of those make people immortal in some way. Your children in one case, your ideas in the other case. And to be honest, I think the web, or let's say Facebook, does provide for both of them. So you find people who you can, you know, spread your genes with, and you definitely find ways how you spread your memes.